So this is currently my favorite place in the mall. It's called Yu's Land. I think it's supposed to be like you and the possessive apostrophe S. And I think it's like a clever play on words, you know? I mean, nobody would do something like that on purpose, right?
Baby rabbit is called Bunny.
It will always be happy if keep on smiling.
It's really cold today, so I don't want to use the heat. Just putting this thing on adds a little bit of flavor, I think, to my limited outfits in these videos. How about this bad boy? And these bad boys. Decided that it would be a good time. Okay, let's just, back to normal. It's okay. Time to talk a little bit about the town that I'm in. I find myself frequenting the mall. There's a lot of stuff there. Very recently, I got a body weight scale, which is really helpful for me in trying to achieve my fitness goals, and a food scale, which is very useful for me in trying to. The mall doubled in size shortly before I moved here. So the mall has two arcades that are a lot like, if you've been to round one, got UFO machines, photo booths, and games. The second one has a VR section. I think it's like tag. I haven't really played. I kind of just went inside and then took a bunch of video and was awestruck. And it's got a Daiso. If you don't know what Daiso is, I like to describe it as the best place to buy things you're not sure that you need, because you can get a lot of different things and they're not of the highest quality. There's a bigger selection, I think, at Daiso here than Daiso where I used to go back in California. But maybe it's because I went to a small Daiso. I remember I went to the one inside the mall at the Mills in Ontario. I picked up quite a few things from Daiso aside from decorations like chopsticks and tongs. And when I realized that I need something better, then on the older side of the mall, there's a place called Awesome Store. And I guess it's pretty awesome. It's got a lot of furniture and holiday items and things like that. Oh, another cool thing about the mall is that sometimes they play Western music. Sometimes I'll just be walking and then I'll hear a song and I'm like, is that the All-American Rejects? Is that Avril Lavigne? Is that Dean Cain? My absolute favorite place when I first started going to the mall was Yu's Land, because they had these fighting game cabinets, and I didn't bring my fight stick with me, even though this laptop is fully capable of running fighting games. So when I went to the mall for the first time, then I kind of got like that arcade experience, and then you can play with other people online, and there are also newer games that haven't released a home version yet, just an arcade version, and I think that's really cool. I got to see some people playing like a JoJo's Bizarre Adventure game, some people playing Gundam games, and there was also a guy that was playing this shuffling dancing game. And I really wanted to do it too, even though my shuffling isn't that great, but I was also really embarrassed, so I didn't try playing the game. But it's a really cool spot. They've got better games, better pizza, Papa John's, they've got cooler prizes in the claw machines, in my opinion. And it seems a little bit more popular than the Sega arcade. And the name is great. Yeah, my second favorite place that I can't exactly go shopping at is, I think it's called Pets Plus or something. I don't know. I have tons of videos of cute dogs and cats from this store, and they're incredibly expensive. Part of the rules in this apartment is that I'm not allowed to have any pets. And while I wouldn't want to have a dog if I have to spend more than half the day away from the dog, thinking about getting a cat, which would be much more independent, sounds like a really cool option. And I probably would break the rules in the apartment and get a cat or something if I weren't allergic. But the other reason why I don't do it is because these pets are super expensive. There's a place called Perfect Suit Joy, and it has character ties sometimes. I found one that was like a Slytherin tie from Harry Potter, and I found Street Fighter ties. I didn't buy any of them until... I didn't buy any of them until I saw this one. This is a JoJo's Bizarre Adventure tie. I got this one and it was pretty expensive even though it was on sale, but it was also the last one that they had of this one. And if you are a fan of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, then you can see Sticky Finger. Now I can go to work and put on kind of a subtle tie, I would say, and nobody has to know that I'm a low-key weeb. Ah, it's too bad I didn't know about these earlier. I definitely would have wanted a gold experience one, but I'm excited to wear it. Oh, other reasons I go to the mall. This past Saturday was White Day. So last time I made a video about all this chocolate that I received on Valentine's Day, and then a month later, culturally, you're supposed to give back on White Day, 3/14, just a month later. And there's this rule called Sanbai Gaishi, which means like triple the return. So the rule of thumb is that you're supposed to give 2 to 3 times the value of whatever item you receive. And then that ended up costing me like 50 bucks in sweets, cookies, crackers. You're not typically supposed to give chocolate. I mean, that's what my manager said, but then I Googled it and then it said that you could give people like white jewelry or white cookies or white chocolate. And I was like, okay. And I did accidentally buy a package of chocolate. I didn't know that it was chocolate. I thought it was like a cracker or a cookie, but it was pretty expensive to give back to all the people that gave me stuff. And I don't even think that I really followed the return rule of thumb, but I was really happy when they told me things like, oh, I'm really excited, or I wasn't doing it because I wanted to get something from you because I know that you're not Japanese, so I didn't think that you would get me anything. Or students that told me like, oh, I couldn't be happier. And that really warmed my heart. I know that 50 bucks isn't like a ton of money. It's just a lot more than I wanted to spend because I'm trying to save my money. JoJo's Bizarre Adventure tie. I got this one and it was pretty expensive. But when I think about it, it's a small price to pay to be able to show them that I care and show them that I'm trying to respect the culture and just to see them smile, because those are some of my favorite students that gave me things. So of course I'd like to return something to them. And of course now with the whole virus thing going on, not really going out to places too much. Sometimes if I didn't have anything to do and then I felt like being out, then I just put on clothes and then I would walk to the mall and walk around the mall and see if something caught my eye. Maybe I wanted to buy something. Maybe I just wanted to watch the puppies playing with each other. It's also really cold and windy lately, and it was even snowing earlier in the afternoon, and I just don't really feel like going out right now. It's nice and cold and I'm feeling nice and cozy, especially with this. And I just slap a blanket on and put on something from Netflix and it feels really relaxing. Or play my guitar. Ooh, there was this bakery that had such a cool cake design. They had this little guy and it looked like he was just chilling in a vat of caramel or whatever. I thought it was so clever. The mall is also a fun place because sometimes I also run into the students that I work with, and it's really cool to see them outside of the classroom. And then I really like when they say hi to me because I think that means that maybe they actually like me. It's all this big onesie that I think would have been a little too small for me, but I was interested in getting it because it was super cheap. I was told the AEON mall was the only thing stopping this town from being considered completely country. Although I think some people have said that since it opened, a lot of small businesses have closed down, which is kind of a shame. The groceries there aren't even the cheapest. The chicken breast is a little more expensive than the supermarket that I usually go to. And there's a little bit more about the town that I'm in, and hopefully I can also make more videos. I've gone to this cool park while it was raining, and I wanted to make a video about that, but I also want to go when the cherry blossoms are in bloom or when the weather's better. But there's a piece of the town that I'm currently living in. A little bit more information, the mall. Oh gosh, I just rewatched some of the video and saw how shiny these parts of my face got. Is it the lighting or am I just really oily?